Vince's Restaurant attacks.
Welcome back to 108.9 The Hawk. Jason Gore.
Geoff the Angry Man Garlock.
We are currently in hour number six of Alice's Restaurant Siege of 108.9 The Hawk. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Hope you're out there celebrating with your loved ones. I wish we were at this point.
So here's what's going on, everyone. For the past 6 hours, we have been brutally attacked by Alice's Restaurant by Arlo Guthrie, a Thanksgiving classic.
It was a classic until I heard it this many times. I did not be expecting to be hearing an 18-minute and 36-second song this many times.
It's too long.
It was too long the first time. All right, and now we are in hour six, and I'm not gonna lie to you, Jason. I think I'm losing it a little bit.
I'm right there with you, Angry Man. Here's the thing about the attack, guys. We don't know when it's going to attack again. You know, and while we think we're ready for it, we're never ready for it.
God, no. And I tell you what, I'm going to tell you that the laughter in that crowd, it really freaks you out. Really disarms you. You feel like you're confused. You're in a haze all of a sudden. It's like, why are they laughing at Arlo Guthrie? This isn't funny. I don't understand what the joke is. I can't understand what Arlo is saying.
He isn't even a comedian. I mean, he isn't even the good Guthrie.
No. He is the worst Guthrie at this point. This Guthrie can burn in hell, but the problem is, they all start laughing, and then he keeps on talking, and he keeps up bringing up Alice in that restaurant. All of a sudden, that confusion, boom, you get attacked again, and it takes all your money. All your money's gone from your wallet.
I've lost $60 so far.
I lost my goddamn car keys. I don't even know where my car is anymore. Thanks for nothing, Arlo.
So we're stuck in the studio. Nobody else is coming in. Thankfully, we do have Big Truck down at the Valley Verde Mall. We're going to check in with him coming up very soon because...
Is he going to save us?
I don't think he can.
This has been... 3 hours is what we allotted for our slot. 3 hours, and we are 6 hours in. Big Truck, you gotta come rescue us from Arlo here.
I'm supposed to start cooking. That's 2 hours ago.
You know, my family, if they're even there anymore, I would imagine they're dead at this point. Waiting this long, starving. They've got no food. All because we keep serving up food at Alice's restaurant. You can't keep having Thanksgivings in this song. Oh God.
Oh God. Oh,
it's back. Damn you!
It sounds like it's gonna be fun.
Maybe they'll start laughing again. Maybe I'll get the joke this time.
Maybe this song's Alice's Restaurant. No. It's about Alice.
And the restaurant. Big Truck coming up, please. Right now, it's Bachman Turner Overdrive taking care of business. I want to wait 0.9 The Hawk.
BTO.
Happy Thanksgiving from 108.9 The Hawk.
Bachman Turner Overdrive taking care of business on 108.9 The Hawk. We do have to apologize for playing that again, but we're pretty shook here at The Hawk.
I didn't even realize we had played it already. Not gonna lie to you. I was just happy to have a reprieve for 5 seconds from Arlo. And look, I mean, I'm not going to apologize for more taking care of business. I mean, it is classic rock. It's at least not a lighthearted but irreverent take on Vietnam War mores and something about a restaurant that they mentioned kind of Thanksgiving, and now we have to listen to it every frickin' Thanksgiving over and over. It's not classic rock. That's my biggest problem, I think, out of all of this. It's questionable if it even should get that label.
So I don't know if listeners, if you know what we're talking about, here's the news sounder.
Alice's Restaurant attacks.
We are still in the midst of an attack on 108.9 The Hawk by the song Alice's Restaurant, a Thanksgiving classic. We don't. We've been here forever, literally. You know, Boss Ron, the station manager, he said that we got to keep doing this. So we're going to keep doing this. Nobody's coming in. Nobody's coming to help us. You know, what do we... 96.8, the Squirt doesn't have to deal with this. They've already shifted to an all-rock holiday tune schedule. And, you know, we're not even doing that until Christmas.
What is wrong with us? What are we doing here? I mean, why aren't we listening to Clarence Clemens yelling at Springsteen and Springsteen yelling back at him? I mean, this is stupid. I don't... Nobody likes this song. Nobody likes Alice's Restaurant. And yet, Ron... You keep forcing it down our throats.
Every hour on the hour is what we were supposed to do, but now it just happens.
I tried. Oh, God.
At Alice's Restaurant.
You know.
Okay, it's gone.
Here's my problem. 2 years. I used to appreciate the song at one point. I'm not going to lie to you. I used to think this was a witty take on a holiday that lost some spirit to me, and it was an angry man tradition at our house. Every Thanksgiving, my family would arrive. I'd go over the old turntable, put that needle on the vinyl, and we would listen to the entirety of Alice's Restaurant. And I tell you,
when my friend and I went up to visit Alice at the restaurant,
and the problem is right around there, Jason, that is where we would be eating the sweet potatoes. Because that was the rule. You listen to it once, and as soon as it's done, you leave. Thanksgiving is over. That's all you need. 18 minutes, 36 seconds. And even that feels extra with family.
You got to eat your whole meal.
Yeah.
In 18 minutes and 34 seconds. And then you're out.
You fit it in. You eat the marshmallows off the sweet potatoes. You get the hell out of my house. But no, now it feels like I'd be eating those goddamn sweet potatoes to the end of eternity, and we're back. No!
With her husband Ray and Foch as a dog, and living in the bell tower that, they got a lot of room downstairs where the pews used to be.
What is he even talking about now?
Having all that room, seeing as how they took out all the pews.
I can't follow it. Who is Ray? There's a dog!
They're garbage. For a long time.
There's a laughing. Why are they laughing again? It's not funny.
It'd be a friendly gesture for us to take the garbage down to the city dump.
Okay. Hopefully that's it. Hopefully that's all there's going to be. But we do have to check in with Big Truck because they are setting up the annual hawk trees at the Val Verde Mall.
Thank God.
Big Truck, what's going on?
Well, it sounds like y'all got some stuff going on over there. Gotta say, happy to be here at the Val Verde Valley Mall and not at the studio.
We are both very envious of you, Big Truck. Could you?
Yeah.
Please take the pain away. What's going down there? What's going down at the Val Verde Mall?
We are having a blast. Everybody's down here. People lined up to go ahead and get their holiday shopping done. You know, Black Friday's tomorrow. And, you know, today we're setting up the hawk trees. Now, what is a hawk tree, you may ask? And that Big Truck is going to drive on up, toot, toot. He's going to tell you what it is. So here's what goes on. Each tree, there are five trees in the Val Verde Valley Mall. And each tree holds a hawk egg containing the names of some kids in need this holiday season. Maybe they're asking for a trapper keeper. Maybe they're asking for a tiny truck. That's what my kids like. Truck Junior, man, he loves a tiny, tiny truck.
You,
and each tree.
You got a kid truck? I didn't even know this.
Truck Junior? Oh, yeah.
How sweet.
He's all grown up now, but I got to say, he still loves a little. I get him a tiny truck every Christmas, and I'm like, Daddy loves you, Truck Junior. And he looks at me and he says, I love you too, Daddy. And man, that's a holiday spirit right there. You can play What a Wonderful World as many times. Or what's the name of that movie?
With It's a Wonderful Life.
It's a Wonderful Life, man.
Oh, no. Big Truck, don't threaten us. It feels like you're threatening us. Are you trying to get Ron to make us watch that movie? over and over again.
I think maybe I'm going to call Ron and see if there's time for that.
No, Chuck, forget about that terrible idea. We've already been poisoned. This holiday's already been ruined. Can you please just get back to these hawk eggs?
Okay. Well, I'll talk to Ron about it over drinks later. So here's what goes on, man. There's 5 hawk trees all throughout the Val Verde Valley Mall, and each tree has a name in an egg, and each tree is protected by an actual live hawk who thinks those eggs are real. Wow. So if you can get out alive with a kid's name in your hand, you help that kid in need.
Wow.
And that's what we're doing. These trees are covered in eggs. And these trees are topped by 5 of the biggest, angriest hawks I've ever seen in my life.
Now, I got to ask you, have these hawks, Big Truck, made any swoops for any of the children pre-picking of the egg yet?
Yeah, they have. They have, like, three of them just swooped down into the Cinnabon.
Oh, boy.
And that was quite the travesty. They had to close it.
I'm sure, as long as they stay away from my Orange Julius. Right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Hawks, back off!
They may go for it, man. They might go for that. They might go for lids.
Oh,
because a hawk likes a hat.
I'm sure. A nice fitted hat.
Yeah, they close the door at lids. They're not letting anybody in because 3 hawks swiped through there, too.
Is the Chess King safe?
Chess King is safe. Nobody's going there. Wicks and Sticks. Nobody's going in there.
Auntie Anne's doing okay.
What is it?
Auntie Anne's pretzels?
Auntie Anne's. No, they're doing fine. No, not even a hawk wants that.
Okay, that's well. So you don't have to besmirch my favorite treat down there. I usually go down there and get an Orange Julius and Auntie Anne's pretzel. But I'm a little scared of the hawks. I'm not gonna lie.
You're eating pure garbage, angry man.
Oh man, don't get me. I wish I could fight you on this one, honestly, but I'm feeling weak.
Yeah, hey, Ron?
No. Yeah.
So here's the idea.
No, Chuck.
Jason Gore and...
Jason, can we cut this transmission? Can we please?
Angry man.
No.
Okay, we're out.
We are screwed. Big Truck sent us down the river with his damn holiday spirit.
I thought for sure it would just be Alice's restaurant, but now we have to watch It's a Wonderful Life.
What's it called?
It's a Wonderful World?
It's a Wonderful World. He doesn't even know what hell he is signing us up for because he can't even remember the damn name of that movie. And now we got to sit there.
And there's the line. Boss Ron's calling. Great.
Oh, God. Here we go.
Great. Well, we'll deal with that. Coming up, we're going to play as much rock as we can in between attacks. But right now, it's Bachman Turner Overdrive taking care of business on 108.9 The Hawk.
Have we?
What do you mean?
I think I'm starting to hear that we've done this one before. We've played.
No, there's literally no way.
Maybe I've just gone crazy. Maybe I'm just, I'm just picturing Alice's restaurant and I feels like now the 2 songs are merged. Into one gigantic, oh my gosh. Are you hearing this? I thought we were listening to BTO. Are we not taking care of business?
It just changed. It just changed.
Did you not control this? This is just happening.
I didn't do that, and they're laughing.
Don't start you laughing. I feel like they're laughing at us now. Laughing at our pain.
What do I do? I'm panicking. Bachman Turner Overdrive on 108.9 The Hawk.
Sounds good. Take care of business.
108.9 The Hawk is just like that can of cranberry sauce you can't do without. You know, the one with all the ridges and lines in it. You dump it out on a plate and grandma's all like, oh wow, I'm just gonna eat that. Classic.
Look. Gonna apologize. That was BTO again, taking care of business. I definitely heard it that time on 108.9 The Hawk.
Bachman Turner Overdrive, taking care of business right here on 108.9 The Hawk.
I just...
Did you do it? Did you back announce it?
I think we both just back announced Where are we? What are we still here? Are we still alive?
We are we're here at Hawk headquarters, the Hawk Nest. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. If you're listening, and if you're out shopping, I maybe enjoy being free.
Enjoy the fresh air. And I hope at the Bed Bath & Beyond you are at, they are not playing Alice's Restaurant. Because
we're in
purgatory.
We're in hour 8 of
Alice's Restaurant Attacks.
And
I feel like I'm going to throw up every single time that bumper starts.
I don't even know why. I mean, it's almost like the news department knew this was going to happen, so they gave us a sounder for it. Nobody produced this today.
I feel like we're in the middle of some Tales from the Dark Side episode. Are we supposed to be learning a moral lesson here at the end, or?
Was that the show late night on Showtime with David Duchovny?
Oh, no, that's Red Shoe Diaries. No,
it's not the same.
I wish we were in a Zalman King's Red Shoe Diaries, because I would be finding out about
it. He hunted for aliens in that, right?
Okay, yes. Yeah, so now you're merging a couple different shows. Now we're in X-Files. No, I thought you were talking about the man who lost his wife and found out after she was died that she had been cheating on him, and that she had a P.O. box and there was 2 Red Shoe Diaries. So he set one up so that he could get letters from other ladies who would like to cheat on their husbands. And I would imagine he jerks off to it.
And then the smoking man wrote him.
Okay, yeah, again, I think our brains are mushy here. I think we're just merging everything.
Got a fantasy. Oh. And he's like, my fantasy deals with smoking.
Oh.
And then David Duchovny's character, who's also in the FBI.
Yes.
Ooh. He says, this is a sexy letter.
Ooh.
And then that weird music plays.
Yes, and then the log lady shows up. Am I merging other shows? Because it all sounds erotic, and I'm, for the first time, feeling a little bit of life in 8th hour of this show. Were we even talking about classic rock anymore? Where are we? What is this?
We are here on 108.9 The Hawk, the 8th hour of the Jason and Angry Man morning show.
Californication. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
The Chili Peppers?
Oh, Duchovny, but also the Chai Peps, it could be on this. I don't know what we're... I've lost it completely. I'm sorry. Go on. Sorry to interrupt.
Management has asked us to play a promo for a brand new show right here on 108.9 The Hawk, so we're going to play that for you, and we'll talk a little bit about it right after this.
Hey, it's me, Mikki Mackmack. Do you miss a time when rock was rock and neon colors combined with black leather were also rock? Me too. That's why I'm the host of Hair House, right here on 108.9 The Hawk. Join me, Mikki Mackmack, every Saturday night from 9 until midnight for the absolute best in hair metal. And I mean the best. Bands like White Lion.
And the children cry.
Whoa, that's a lot of metal. Dokken.
In my dreams, it's still the same.
I'm scared of that guy. Britney Fox. That's too much metal. Winger.
She's only 17.
Somebody shut the steel mill down. Too much metal. And we'll never fucking play Nirvana. Hair House with me, Mikki Mackmack. Saturday nights, right here on 108.9 The Hawk.
Yeah, so we're all excited to hear Hair House right here on 108.9 The Hawk. Mikki Mackmack's been around for a very, very long time.
He has.
So it is good.
Seems like he shows up everywhere, right? I mean,
yeah.
He's shown up in every era of music in a weird way.
Yeah. Yeah, he's just, if there's a man that knows about hair metal, it is Mikki Mackmack, and we're very happy to have him. I wish I could be more excited. Under other circumstances, I would be more excited, but right now I am just shaken to my core. And I don't even want to do this, but we do have to do the Val Verde Community Calendar. It is a community service of 108.9 The Hawk and Val Verde Valley Radio Partners. Coming up December 1st, we've got the Chili Roast. That's happening down at the Val Verde Fire Station 3. Get on down there from 5 until 7. If you can roast your own chili, it's free.
And coming up, it looks like December 4th at Fletchy's over there on Route 46. Oh,
I love Fletchy's.
Yeah, they're going to be having a hot dog roasting contest.
Wow.
Yeah. So split your own dogs and scarf them down your throat. That's the classic Fletchy's catchphrase that we all know.
I have it on a t-shirt and a mug.
Yeah, I have it a bumper sticker. So make sure you get down there. Bring your own toppings. We're supposed to remind you of that. Yeah. Fletchy's isn't providing after last year, and I think we all remember what happened there.
We do remember, and we do remember the victims.
Yes.
December 9th, Chestnuts, down at Chestnuts. Chestnuts, of course, the premier male dance club in Val Verde. You need some chestnuts roasted? They said they will do them in the back. That's all it says.
Oh,
there's no other details.
It's a classy place. I'm sure it's on the up and up.
It is on the up and up.
What do we got here? December 17th. Bring your family down to Uncle Petruccio's because we're going to be having a barn busting bush lighting ceremony. I'll be honest, I've never really understood. I don't know. Uncle Petruccio is some sort of, it's not American fare, as we're used to in Val Verde. So they must be doing some sort of holiday tradition that's above my head. But I'm sure it's fun for all the Petruccio fans out there.
December 22nd, the Snow Cone Man's back. Now, of course, we know that the Snow Cone Man has been incarcerated for the past 15 years, so it's a little unsettling to know that the Snow Cone Man's back.
Yeah.
But it's also a little comforting to know that some of the best snow cones I remember from my childhood, when I would be chased by a man in his snow cone mobile, right through the streets of Val Verde.
Yes, that's youth. That's the youth of Val Verde. And also this, what is this one? December 22nd. Oh no. The Lollipop Man is back.
Oh, God.
You can't, this is what we've been saying. You can't have the Lollipop Man and the Snow Cone Man coming back at the same time. Of course, the Lollipop Man has gotten out of incarceration as well. Hopefully they will not be competing for chasing us down the streets like we were children and would terrify us. But he does have some of the best lollipops in town with flavors that you've never imagined. So watch out for the competition on that day, I guess. Be forewarned, because it's a tasty treat, but also might get you in the end.
And with that, that wraps up our community calendar right here, a service of 108.9 The Hawk and Val Verde Valley Radio Partners. And let's check back in down at the Val Verde Valley Mall. Big Truck, help us out, buddy.
Big Truck? Are you there? Big Truck, are you hurt? Are you okay?
It got me.
Oh no.
Oh, Guthrie just came right through here.
Did you hear the laughter?
It's all I can hear, man. He wiped out the whole mall. Lids is gone.
God damn it. Where am I supposed to get my family all their fitted hats for Christmas? Are you bleeding? Are you okay? Do you need me to call you a doctor, Big Truck?
I'm going to need some services, but I got to give y'all a warning here.
What?
He said he's coming back for you.
Oh, God, no.
He said he's coming. And, Geoff, I got to tell you.
What?
Buddy.
What?
He's driving your Chevy Malibu.
God damn it. I knew it. God, see, he's taking it.
Man, he drove it through here like it was Blues Brothers 2000, not the original.
Oh, of course. No, the classic in 2000. That's when it really all came together. I need you to tell me something and be honest with me.
Yeah, yeah.
Is the Orange Julius still standing? Oh, don't say it.
It's gone, man. It's gone.
No! Oh, big truck. Big truck.
Big truck.
Oh, gosh.
The feed just died.
I can't believe we lost him. I'm so worried now. I bet you that we've got loose hawks running around. Oh, God. Bring that one up. Oh, God, he came. Down.
I'd back. Rather deal with loose hawks than this.
Come take me, loose hawks! Because I can't deal with Alice's restaurant anymore! When we
got a phone Bachman Turner Overdrive. 108.9 The Hawk.
Gobble, gobble. Gobble, gobble, gobble. 108.9 The Hawk.
108.9 The Hawk, the number two classic rock radio station in Val Verde.
Why are you reminding me?
With Bachman Turner Overdrive, taking care of business. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. We are in hour 17 of the siege.
I'm proud of you, Bachman. I'm proud of you that you could still say Happy Thanksgiving throughout all this.
I'm more proud of Overdrive.
But I'm most proud of Turner. Thank you, Turner.
You know, Rick Overdrive was the best member of that band.
Frank Turner really nailed it, though.
Randy Bachman, Frank Turner, Rick Overdrive. What other band do you need? I tell you what band I don't need. The band backing up Arlo Guthrie.
I wish they'd all die. I wish they just died. I can't. This is hour 17. I don't think I'm ever going to see my family again.
Hey, Bachman. Do you think that if you had a chance, you would take care of business?
That's a good question, Turner O. You know,
like every day.
Every day, I'd be taking care. You know what? And I would try. I try one way, but then I'd go every way. I just say,
Do you know whenever I enter a gym, you know the first thing I say at the top of my lungs is
TCB
workout.
Yeah, yeah. That's you
got. Everyone's like, yeah. They're like, hey, Overdrive just walked in. He's ready to work out.
Exactly.
And I'm just like. Well, here we are again. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. And it comes that time of the show where we got to do the community calendar service of 108.9 The Hawk and Val Verde. Val Verde Valley Radio Partners. And
VVRP. VVRP BTO.
So, December 2nd, make sure you get on down to Hogstiff's because they're going to have a pile of them.
December 7th, it'll fetch you down. You got to pull it on up and then it's going to see. And go with Alice. And you never say you're down, you get arrested. Yeah.
December 8th, Chesty's. Chester is, they're going to make some slow moves and, they're going to, a lot of hands.
Uncle 24th, Patroclios is going to come down and you're going to see it through and it's going to, and then I told him, no, I'm going to go over to there. And then the cops came, Vietnam, and you just get, yeah, you just get it.
December 22nd, Snowcone Man's back. Snowcone Man. He dug out.
December 22nd, the ice cream. A man's coming down and he dug out.
They both dug out.
They get and they dug it.
And they in? And under fence and now free.
Now they didn't have, they'll slit your throat. Yeah.
And that's community calendar. That's on
Valverde time. Very tight.
Hey, so, what's your favorite Thanksgiving song?
Is it? Are there Johnny the Fox meets Jimmy the Weed? Is that Thanksgiving song?
I think it is. I think that's probably my favorite.
Yeah, I think doesn't Phil talk about getting a turkey or something?
I like Jay Giles Band Stuffin'.
Oh, yeah.
It's got that sax solo.
Yeah,
and Peter Wolf's just screaming Stuffin' over it.
Yeah.
I also really like Eddie Money's Stuffin'.
Yeah.
He covered it.
It's a good cover. Montrose, Rock Candy. That's just for the kiddies.
That's for the kids.
Yeah.
You put the Rock Candy out on the Thanksgiving table.
Yeah. That's an Angry Man classic.
I like Robert Plant's solo, Stairway to Stuffin'.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
Phil Collins played drums on that.
He did. Wow. Speaking of Phil, Phil Collins in the air tonight, Stuffin'. Good song. You know, the guy who gave him that Stuffin', he brought him to a concert and he had him in the front row and he said, thank you for that Stuffin'. And you know what the guy said? That was dressing, not Stuffin'. True story.
Happened. Wow.
Yeah.
Hey, that's the way. That's what you hear here at 108.9 The Hawk. You usually hear it in a very more concise way, not from two men who have been doing this for 17 hours.
I can't believe this is our life now. This is what we're going to be doing. I don't think Thanksgiving's ever going to end. I think, oh, God damn it. Hey there, everybody, down at The Hawk, and this is Arlo Guthrie, and I was just trying to sing a little song to you for this Thanksgiving holiday, and I was...
Why?
Well, I went down to Buckham's Creek, and then I saw down in Turner Overdrive, and I went there, and I saw that, there was a police officer, and, well, if I had to break it down for you, I was actually sent by the Squirts. A little...
Oh, come on.
Thanksgiving rigmarole from the Squirts. I just wanted to show a little healthy rivalry, but in fact, they only paid for 17 hours as a tag. It wasn't Ron's choice. This was the Squirts, so no hard feelings. And I'm just going to go down and go back down to the jail and then sound about Vietnam. And no hard feelings there, so happy Thanksgiving. And... thanks for the Malibu. God damn it. There goes my Chevy Malibu. Damn you, Arlo!
It's over.
Is that it?
I think it might be over.
Are we saved?
The sun is coming through the clouds.
There's a light on the horizon.
Is rigmarole a prank to the Guthrie family? Is that what they refer to pranks as?
You know,
as rigmaroles?
I'll take it at this point. You know, whatever they think. It, yes, apparently they think a prank is a rigmarole and a rigmarole is a prank. And whatever it is, as long as we don't have to hear Alice's Restaurant ever again.
You know what? It's kind of funny. It was I when he was telling me those things and it wasn't making any sense, I wanted to laugh.
You understood the audience all of a sudden. I
understood the audience.
I had a little bit of a chuckle in my heart too. Maybe we were wrong about Arlo. Maybe he actually is a wonderful song maker and joke maker all at once. And
maybe
he's a hippie. Oh, he's a hippie.
He's a hippie.
He's a hippie. He's a rigmarole hippie.
Well, guys, I think we can finally go see our families if they'll take us back.
I hope they're still there. I hope you save some rolls for me.
Yeah. Oh, I hope that Big Truck got some help down at the Val Verde Valley Mall. Remember that the hawk trees are going to be put back up. The hawks will be contained when the Val Verde Valley Mall reopens tomorrow after today's Alice's Restaurant attack.
Please go down there. No sharp, sudden movement. So remember,
none. Please.
They are just as gun shy as we are now after this whole event.
Probably more. Probably more.
They are animals.
Yeah. Oh, but hey, we'll be back on the Jason and Geoff the Angry Man morning show tomorrow morning, and we're going to leave you with a classic. You know what it is, Geoff.
CB.
We'll see you next time on 108.9 The Hawk.